And also, we have one more. We have one more announcement. Matt Glafcke, a good friend of ours, he and his family have become a mission family from our parish, and they will be stationed in Haiti. And Matt would like to come up and just give you some information about what they've been doing since they've been become a mission family. So let's have a warm welcome for Matt.
Thank you, John. Thank you, people, community of St. James. It's wonderful to be with you this Gaudete Sunday, this joyous Sunday, to feel your love and your devotion to the Lord Jesus Christ and the hope of his coming very soon. As John said, my family and I, my wife Katie, and our four daughters and one son are trained now to be lay Catholic missionaries with a lay Catholic apostolate called Family Missions Company. And what that means now is for at least the next 2 years of our life, we've committed in a very real way to serving that great commission that comes from both Matthew and Mark to go to the ends of the earth and preach the gospel, bring the good news, bring salvation to those who might not have heard it or those who might misunderstand the word. So we are committed to and have learned that we're serving the people of Haiti. So pray for them, pray for their hearts, and pray for us as we're sent forth there. And what that means is it's a little town called L'Asile. It's about 75 miles from Port-au-Prince, the capital, which everything runs through. The lifeblood of Haiti goes through that, the one city that has everything, basically. And everywhere else does not have very much. It's the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere, so the need is great, the need is real. And what we've realized is that the best thing that we can bring to them is the good news through Christ our Lord. The gospel today from Luke talks about that through John the Baptist as he's preparing the way for the Lord. And he says, he who has two coats, share with one who has none. He who has food, do the same. And we're called, again, as this family of missionaries to bring that as well, to bring human dignity through Jesus to these people. And I said it's about 75 miles from the capital, but that takes us about 6 hours to get there, for they do not have any infrastructure. There's no roads, there's no cars, really. They're just a very poor people. And as I was preparing for this, I was realizing, you know, what is it that we can give to these people? What is it that you have fed us here at St. James as this community of believers that's allowed us to hear this word and to meditate on the things that Jesus has given us? And I came across this quote by Mother Teresa, a wonderful missionary heart, and she said, "I cannot help them because I do not have anything, but I go to give them joy. I go to give them hope and the love of Jesus." And it's just very real to us and our family and our call. And I wanted to come here again to say thank you, for this would not be possible for our family to do this without your generous financial support, as well as the prayers that you've been giving to our family. They're very real. As we are sent forth, we hold the hand of the poor, and we hold your hand here in Sussex, Wisconsin. Menomonee Falls, I guess. We're from Sussex, but close enough. We're all Wisconsin. We're from Wisconsin. Yes, just in a very real sense, you're holding our hands as we hold the hand of the poor. And so you're one with them as we are one with them. Again, Mother Teresa said in different ways for a mission to happen, some give by going, others go by giving. And without both, you don't have mission. You do not have a mission. Her words just ring so true to me because I do not know much about Haiti. I've never been there even yet. We prepare to leave at the end of January. But one of the men who helped set up the mission for the Family Missions Company said, you know, you fly into Port-au-Prince. And I said, oh, what's Port-au-Prince like? And he said, it's very much like Calcutta. I said, well, I've also never been to Calcutta, but Mother Teresa had, and I knew that the need is very great there. So her words ring true to me now more than ever. And just a couple more words on what it feels like for us is, and what we've realized in these couple months of formation in Louisiana is we were just trained as a family, all of us. My daughter here, Josephine, is just as much a missionary as I am. And it's wonderful to see Jesus Christ working in her life in a very real way, as she also literally holds the hands of the poor, holds the babies, and gives her testimonies in churches as we share what it is that Christ has allowed and done for us in our hearts to the people who are there. And we invite them to do the same, for we're here to make real bonds, real relationships with them. And I realize that we're touching Christ's body in the poor, in the distressing image of the poor, as Mother Teresa sometimes says. For the love of God is primarily displayed in how we treat our neighbors. And we cannot love God without loving our neighbor, but we cannot fully love our neighbor without loving God. And again, all of these words are just ringing true to us in a very real sense, just as we prepare our hearts in a very real sense for Jesus to come, that hope, that truth, that light is the primary thing that we need going forth. So if you want to know anything else about our mission, what it looks like for us, how you might possibly be able to support us in the things that we'll be doing there in a very real way, they live on less than a dollar a day, and we're here to distribute goods and alms and services, mainly Jesus, but in other ways, the dignity of the human, if it's not fed, it's hard to seek Jesus with all your heart if all you're looking for is some food. So we ask you to prayerfully discern how you might be able to help this mission as we're sent forth here from you all, our community of St. James as missionaries from St. James here in Wisconsin to hold that hand of the poor. So my daughter and I will be in the back after Mass. So seek us out. Honestly, I'd love to share and also hear what Jesus is doing in your lives, for I know it's great, it's powerful. Your testimony is wonderful and it still burns strong in my heart. So I thank you all. God bless you this Advent and Merry Christmas.